Let's all do that stupid jump shot.
Yeah. Everyone jumped at the wrong time. That's the largest camera I've ever seen.
And it's on video.
Lowe's home improvement.
I had
Canes in hand, hats off head. Jump like this.
Yeah. No. Yes, yes, I demand the mutton chops.
Guys, scooch this way.
Scooch
like this.
Scooch.
Let's join.
Nice.
All men Napoleon.
Okay, guess what, man?
Darn, we just lost the complete ratio.
She's in the way of my. She has my heart somewhere.
Yes, there's photographic evidence of me in nice clothing. That's
oh, that's
good.
Right. It is a purple parasol.
No, you did the dual wheel. Both of them. Really good.
I did. Yeah,
I got you.
What?
Hand shaking.
I like how you're gonna walk away right after the hand shaking. You're like, okay, we're gonna play, what?
Can I land it?
Say, that's not mine.
That's not mine. Oh, I get it. That's not mine.
Wow, that's
cool.
Brian,
emote.
Up here.
No, happy.
She's done.
Where's the flowers?
And out. How's
that happy?
Holy smokes.
Oh, pretty.
It's cute.
Yes.
Hold it up sideways.
Work video. Then turn it at a 45-degree angle.
It's like pulling.
Smile.
Yeah.
No, not like creepy.
No, he's talking.
I can talk and smile.
You cannot.
You are not a ventriloquist. Do not drink a glass of water.
Okay. I like water.
Can you say the alphabet?
L-M-O-D?
Brother.
The other way.
There you go. Yeah.
Hello, my darling. Hello, my honey. Hello, my love.
I don't know.
I can't stop. That's all.
I will go get
them. No,
they're probably.
Okay.
They're like.
Sorry.
Follow the finger, Brian. Follow the finger.
I don't want
to. Not over there.
Posing because Lindsay, we're cool.
Oh, okay.
Everyone look up there.
We're a bunch of posers. We are. I know.
I feel like I've done this more stream than that. Diana, you need to be
Jason.
Here. I need to be over there. Why? I was trying to come in. Oh! Right, everyone
yeah.
witnessing what happened there, and, you know,
make it look embarrassing.
I'm gonna get beat later, but I'm sorry.
I'm trying to speak, man.
So thank you all for showing up. Can you hear me in the back? All right. Woo-hoo! Can I do a one? Up here to flounder.
You're the second man in life, of course.
What? Speak to you? I will speak to you. Look. Thank you for showing up. How are you doing? How's everyone
here? It's the inside, man.
Did you tie it yourself?
Die. No.
Thank you.
I am so glad James taught me that. I've actually shot more for Wayne this year than I've done for Francis, so.
The best thing happened while you're dancing. Things that you would not do at home come naturally on the floor. For dancing soon becomes romancing. When you hold a girl in your arms that you've never held before. Even guys with two left feet come out all right if the girl is sweet. If by chance their cheeks should meet while dancing, proving that the best things happen while you
Woo! baby, I'm shuffling.
Almost flawlessly, pretty much flawlessly, exactly how we intended. Everyone did their thing. Some people did show up in the middle of it, but it didn't matter. They were too focused on each other. I think it went very well.
I think tonight went very fabulous. I'm extremely happy that everyone's actually smiling all at once. Both families are together. It's amazing, and you know, I'm happy for them both. You know, it's a pretty good night for them, and hopefully, you know, it's great.
It went very well. It was smooth, very easy to transition, and it went well. Brian's dancing could use a little work, but we got years to do that, so.
I think tonight went very well. I was very proud of my sister and Andrew. They wrote their own vows, and I think they spoke to how their future is going to be. I believe that they're going to be very faithful to one another and very committed, so I think it went very well. It was a great representation of who they are.
I think tonight went wonderful. This afternoon, tonight, it was absolutely beautiful. I was tearing up the entire ceremony. I had to dab my eyes a few times. I could just Michelle from where I could see Thor looking. His face was glowing, and he was happy, and he was in love, and it was just the sweetest thing ever. I loved it, and then your dances were just amazing. I don't know why I didn't expect that, because it's both of you, but I wasn't expecting it, and it was awesome. It was great, and we're having a fun party inside right now, and everything is good. Life is good.
Tonight, you know, I think I was on my A game. You know, I mean,
I mean, the other team did bring out the, you know, the other stops and everything. You know, that one goal by Michelle was amazing. I didn't think it was going to go in the, you know, the puck was not going to go in the goal, but fortunately Thor brought out his Warhammer and just, you know, beat it right back, and he got a touchdown. So he's not been slicing as much lately. But all in all, you know, you know, both teams played great, but in the end, one of us had to win. Tonight went awesome. I mean, this is being totally honest now, I've got my joking out. It was a beautiful service. It was one of the best. I love the tradition with the knot tying. All the colors were great. The style was elegant and timeless. Really wonderful. The dances were amazing. Without doubt, the best dancing I've ever seen at a wedding I've ever seen. All three of them were perfect, and that last one was incredible, just the amount of creativity went into it. I was so amazed. And everyone had a good time, you know, everyone's just having a wonderful, fun time, so I don't think you could ask for a better wedding, honestly. This was really amazing, so.
They went.
I think it went a resounding success. It was kind of funny because I was nervous. Am I looking you in the eyes, like, even though you're not?
Look me in the eyes.
I thought it was a resounding success. I was really not nervous, but have you ever gotten those like jitters when you're just about to go somewhere? You're like, I want to do it. Let's go. And then you're like not able to go, so you're like, eh. It's like the groom is basically essentially useless to the whole process, and it's like, what am I doing? I want to do something. Just show up. But I want to do more. So it was good. It was a long story, incredibly long. So yeah. It was good.
Tonight went fabulously, even with all of the little hiccups that we experienced along the way. So it was awesome.
And everything went great, the ceremony.
Oh, yes. Everything went smooth. Everyone laughed. Everyone enjoyed themselves. It was exactly what we wanted.
How was your first dance?
Hilarious and fun and the best thing we ever could have done.
How'd you guys prepare for that? He said it was all you.
It was. It was me. So, you know, feel a little bit bad about that, but he'll get over it. He enjoyed himself, so that's all that matters.
Listen, he probably like would have been like, yeah, I want to learn how to do that. It's great, you know. I could see him.
We tried to do a formal dance, and he failed miserably. So we did something else instead.
That's not what someone would expect?
No, it's not. But it's not what someone would expect, but...
You could also say he does things no one else would expect.
It's true. Yes, he does things no one else would expect
to. 5 years? They were given a choice. Well, Brian was given a choice. He was either to start a family or go traveling. So whatever he chooses is where they're going to be. They're going to have about 2 or 3 kids by then, or passports with at least 8 stamps on it. So we'll see. But whether together or not, definitely, they are some of the best people I've ever seen, best couples I've ever seen, and yeah, it's going to be awesome.
5 years.
How would I see them in 5 years? Well, in 5 years, I see them still being happily married, seeing them trying to do their future, you know, kids, maybe one or two, maybe a couple little girls, maybe a couple little boys, just, having kids, both doing their careers, having fun. Still happy. Hopefully they're, you know, still smiling like they did today. And oh, that great hoopla.
Still happy. Still a couple. I can see them doing quite well. So, they'll be good.
I see them as parents living in a cute little house. Michelle's probably going to be a teacher of sorts some way. I know she wants to run her own school or run her own classroom. So, and I think Andrew's going to be busy with doing what he feels is right, whether it's with politics or becoming a pastor or other things that he's talked to me about. So, I think they're going to support each other in whatever it is they set out to do, whether it is the... their careers or parenthood.
I see them happy and at peace and with babies. We're gonna have babies.
How many babies?
maybe only one, maybe another one on the way in 5 years. You both are going to be great parents.
Oh, in 5 years, I think probably in management, you know, not your job, but in 5 years, you know, I'd like to be doing something with, you know, just rising that corporate ladder, and I'm sure they do too in 5 years, so. I would say, well, I mean, obviously, Michelle has graduated at this point, right? Or is she graduating? Well, she'll be done with that. I'm sure they're going to be farther along. They have very clear ideas of what they like to do, so I'm sure they'll just be farther along in that. You know, I didn't realize that Thor was, you know, so political and actually has some really, you know, thoughtful ideas and stuff like that. I don't even necessarily agree, like, what he says and not necessarily, you know, mirror what this person's saying. In fact, I don't even know. I don't think we've talked as much, but I just know he's very active, and I know Michelle's very driven as well, so I think just farther along that, I know they're going to be, you know, together and happy, so.
Well, okay. There's a couple places. She would like to go back to from whence she came, which would be Presque Isle. She would like to go back up there for a little while, or maybe out west. I'd like to do that myself. And there's also a possibility for a political career in my future. I'm a state committee man now with the Republican Party, so I basically now have the ability to pursue a political... I guess technically I'm an elected official, so at least for 2 years I'll be doing that. And it's kind of cool. It's a fun thing. And she has a business that she would like to start, which I will let her speak on, because I don't have the ability to do it the justice that she does. So in 5 years, I'm assuming... Which is probably a bet. Okay, in 5 years, we're going to basically be either up there or out west, and we're going to be with a new business and starting some sort of career for me politically. That would be where I see this going. Oh, and little toddler baby thing.
Red hair or not red hair?
Probably redhead. I would say if it comes from me, it's going to be a genetic mutation. It will be a freak. Sorry, honey.
How many toes? Fingers? On?
Huh?
Never mind.
How many kids do you want?
Uh-oh.
No, that's a legitimate question. I want at least... No, I do not want 10 babies. I want at least one of each. Two children. I was going to say two boys, two girls. No, at least a boy and a girl. I will go up to three if I can't have one of each, i.e. if I have like two girls, I'll go up to three, and if I get a third girl, I'll just say it wasn't meant to be. So that's fine. But yeah, that's how many I would like.
I see us with a little house somewhere, probably on a lake, because he has to be by water, and I'm not a fan of the ocean, because I like very close spaces all to myself, with at least one child. So he has to get on that.
I've given him all the advice I can, really. Biggest one I've ever given him was don't sweat small stuff, and... You know, I mean, it sounds corny, but count your blessings. That's really about it. I mean, I don't... He's doing everything right now. I'm really happy for him.
Don't take anything too serious, and don't take everything for granted. Remember, you only have so many years to live, and you never know when your time's going to come up. So live life to the fullest. Remember, wake up, smile, say I love you before you leave. Say I love you when you wake up. And, you know, you go to bed, smile at the end of the day. Just put all that crap that, you know, if you're fighting that day.
Shut them up! Woo!
If they're fighting that day, just at the end of the day, sit down in a room together, talk it out, hug, kiss, make out what you gotta do. Smile, go to bed, say I love you before you go to bed, and hopefully you'll wake up the next morning with the I still love you.
Take everything with a grain of salt. Just take a breather. If things get rough, don't look at the negative outlooks. Oh, just focus on the positive. You guys will do good, and I wish the best of you.
Yes, I do have advice for them. My advice is to hang on to each other, even though times are going to get hard, because they always do, and to always remember what it was like when they first started out. Remember the first love that they had. And to be real with each other. Because life is going to present them with hardships, and I think the best way for them to overcome is if they're true to each other and real to each other, and maintain their love for each other.
My advice is to love each other, to respectfully listen to each other, to know when to give you your own space, and to love. Love. I love you guys.
Oh, advice. Yeah, you know, watch out where that husky goes. Don't cheat that yellow snow. Words of Frank Zappa. So, other advice. You know, when you do cut up the can and get the lid off, you know, just be very careful because those can lids are very sharp. At that point, you could easily cut yourself. I mean, suck it up. It can be very painful. So that's, you know, don't, you know, feel like that. You know, you just don't. Because you know, if you do, then it's, you know, so it's like, yeah. Don't sweat the small stuff, and it's all small stuff. I know that's cliche, but honestly, everything's an opportunity to laugh. Every single thing, like, could just be, and I think they do this, so I don't think this is really much advice that they need, but, you know, at every step, it's, you know, it's always just an opportunity to be like, look at this, this is so funny, this is so great, that, you know, and it's with the person I love, so, I think with that in mind, there's like, really never any problems in life. Everything's just a joy. It's always a lark and a laugh, and you know they both have good senses of humor. So,
oh, who's gonna see this?
Them?
Just them?
Or if they want,
okay,
to
I was gonna share a story
public.
That only they know, but that's fine. Good luck and Godspeed, man. Love you both.
Michelle, keep him away from lakes. That's all I gotta say. Keep him away from lakes and any bodies of water where he can lose his shorts and pop up without them. That's all I gotta say. Best of luck.
Inside jokes. Oh, I can tell you something. So, when I was little, and my brother was little, we were told that our mother was pregnant, but we didn't know whether it was gonna be a boy or a girl. So my brother was kind of sparring with me word-wise, and he would say, boy, and I would say, girl, and he would say, boy, and I would say, girl. And I said to myself, you know what, I know how to one-up my brother. And I prayed for a girl, and that's what came. And it's a really great thing that it did, because that's who Andrew ended up with. So
I am responsible for Thor. Everybody thinks it's a grander story than it is. It was at Lindsay's house. Lindsay's right over here. And I was there. I was meeting Thor for the first time. He said, hi ladies, my name is Thor. And I said, really? I know someone named Thor, because I do. And yeah, and that's just where it went. And it stuck, and I hope it stays forever. Because I will never call you Andrew, I will never call you Brian. You will always be Thor.
Yeah, no, for real. Yeah, really, just, this was amazing. And make this be the best day up till now, and make each day the best in the future. I guess from your perspective, it would be that direction. Depends on which way you're thinking. If you're in the DeLorean, I don't know, who knows? It's timey-wimey, wibbly-wobbly stuff. So, no, but honestly, just have a great time. You guys are wonderful. I love you both. And let's have a wonderful, fun time. And I'll see you soon.
I had always wanted to be a husband. Some people want to, like, you know, run out and be a firefighter or go arrest cops or something. Yeah, no, that doesn't make sense. Vigilantism? Batman. So, some people have always wanted to do stuff like that, and I kind of always wanted to be, like, a husband. I had a lot of bad luck throughout the course of my life getting to the point where that would be something that was an option. And, I'd always kind of wanted to be a dad and all this stuff, you know. Secretly, didn't really ever tell many people that, but I always really, really wanted to be that. And so Michelle came along, or you came along, since I'm supposed to be addressing it to you. And basically, one of the things that you did was you gave me hope that I'd be able to have that. And when things weren't going so well at certain points in our relationship, you stuck through, and so thank you, because now I'm a husband to the most fabulous woman I could ever imagine being a husband to. And we're going to have a long and happy marriage. So, you know, we understand a lot of things. Like closing the bathroom door and... I'm kidding. But...
Toilet
no.
seat.
Privacy, yeah. Privacy, cleanliness, communication, which is key, and cooperation. So thank you, honey. Thank you for making me a husband to a fabulous wife. And stutter when I speak. And I even got misty-eyed when you were coming up the runway. Is that what... Yeah. Okay, there's no planes here. Love you, bye.
I do hope that He does kiss me every single day when I walk through the door. And he is the most fun-loving, awesome, caring, little bit whiny man that I've ever met. But I am very, very happy to be able to spend the rest of at least my life or his with him.